Now you will listen the special update in English.
In Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir, the All Parties Hurriyat Conference has condemned fresh escalation in killing of innocent people, torturing of young and old, molestation of women, and ransacking of civilian properties by Indian occupation forces in the territory. All Parties Hurriyat Conference General Secretary Maulvi Bashir Ahmed Irfani, in a statement issued in Srinagar, shared the horrific details of war crimes committed by Indian troops in several villages of Tral in Pulwama district in the dark of Monday night. He said that the troops, hailing from local military camp, broke into the villages, forced people out of their houses, tortured men and molested women. The APHC leader hailed the people for demonstrating courage to help protest against the present military action. He called upon the United Nations and human rights organizations to conduct probe into the brutalities by the troops in Tral and elsewhere in the occupied territory. Indian police barred PDP President Mehbooba Mufti from visiting the victims of Indian brutalities in Tral and locked the main gate of her Gupka residence in Srinagar today. Mehbooba Mufti, in a tweet, said that the troops raided a woman, Ishrat Jan, tore her clothes before she fell unconscious because of head injuries during the operation in Sir Jagir area of Tral town. The chairman of International Forum for Justice and Human Rights, Jammu and Kashmir, Muhammad Hassan Onto, while lashing out at the Indian Army for fresh incident in Tral, said that Indian forces are habitual of resorting to such brutality in occupied territory. He urged the international human rights bodies to take cognizance of these human rights abuses in the occupied territory. Meanwhile, Indian troops continued their violent cordon and search operations in different areas of Srinagar, Baramulla, Kupwara, Pulwama, Shopian and Kashtwar areas today. In turn, doctors at Government Medical College, Srinagar and the employees of Department of Information and Public Relations held protest demonstrations against the Indian government's recent move of allocating 50% of PG seats in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir to All India Quota and arbitrary orders issued by Director Information respectively. The Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir High Court has quashed the illegal detention of two Kashmiris by observing that the detainees were not provided with the materials relied upon by the detaining authority. Tehreek-e-Wahdat-e-Islami Jammu Kashmir, at a meeting of its advisory council in Budgam, said that Kashmiris have been fighting against illegal occupation of their homeland by India since 1947, and despite all its oppression, New Delhi has failed to suppress their spirit for freedom. Former Indian minister and senior Congress leader, Professor Saifuddin Soz, in a statement issued in Srinagar, said that BJP leaders have resorted to spread white lies on Kashmir, especially on abrogation of Article 370, while the fact is there is widespread anger among the Kashmiris on the abrogation of the article. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi is well known all over the world for his expansionist design under Nazi replica Hindutva fascist ideology, which poses a grave threat to not only peace and stability of South Asian region, but to the humanity as a whole. India has witnessed a rising tide of fascism since Modi assumed power in 2014. Towing the line of his mother organization RSS's fascist philosophy, he is the kingpin of the campaign of Hindu dominance in mainstream Indian politics and the region. Political analysts keep warning that if not roped in, Modi's extremist Hindutva policies will have serious implications for not only South Asia but the whole world.